And it's not just 50 mil, man. Other folks are longing in too as well, man. Amen. 1 John chapter 3, verse 2. And you may stay seated. Beloved, now are we the sons of God, and it does not yet appear what we shall be. But we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Let me read that again. Beloved, now are we the sons of God, and it does not yet appear what we shall be. But we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Amen. Our identity in Christ.
Yes.
Our identity in Christ. Amen. As I said on Wednesday, everybody in here has some form of ID on them, or they should. Amen. Probably the baby doesn't. Amen. Amen. But everybody else in here does. Whether it's a work ID, whether it's a driver's license, a state ID, a school ID, a social security card, birth certificate, there's some form of ID that we carry around. It's by law that we should have some ID on us. If you're pulled over by the police, amen, they want to see your identification. Usually your driver's license. If they stop you on the street and ask you for ID, you should have something to identify who you are. Amen? Identity, amen, drives everything in our life. Amen. And this is why so many people, you know, are subject to identity theft. And when someone steals their identity, it looks like their whole life, their whole world has come crashing down, because now somebody has taken charge of their identity and messed their identity up. I have a sister who was a victim of identity theft years ago, and she said she has to carry a file with her everywhere she goes, and it's to prove who she is. Amen. Glory to God. And so, like I said, you carry some form of ID on you, your driver's license or work-related ID. And what's on the ID is your name, usually a picture, some identifying characteristics such as your address, your job title if it's a work ID, the authority that issued the ID to you, either the job or the state of Illinois. Often, and many times, your signature is at the on the bottom of the card, amen. And without that ID, you really can't do much, amen. You can't, listen, without an ID, you can't cash your check, amen. Somebody give you a check, you don't have your ID, and your bank doesn't know you, amen. You just got a piece of paper that you can't even use, amen. Glory to God. So if somebody asks, who are you, amen, you can present your ID, and it has everything that they need to know. Amen? Identities tell us who we are. Elder Clark, amen. Where we live, how and where we can travel, amen. Your passport is a form of ID. You can present that, amen. And you definitely got to have a passport when you're going out of the country, amen, so that you can get back and forth. And if you, let me tell you, God forbid you go out the country with a passport and you lose it, and then you try to get back into the United States, Trump is not going to let you in, y'all. Amen. Glory to God. Our identity drives what we can buy with our finances, what qualifies us for employment. And let me tell you something. You know they use your ID to run a credit check on you, to run your ID, to run your background, amen, to see if you got a felony or not on your record, amen. Your identity tells everything about you. And you better protect your identity, especially that social security number, amen. And so that's why we are so devastated when our identity is stolen. Amen. And knowing our spiritual identity is even greater. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. We have to know who we are, Sister Rachel. Amen. We're not just people put here on this earth going aimlessly about just doing whatever we want to do. Amen. But when we became saved and sanctified, amen, we became somebody. Amen. You know what I said? When we became saved and sanctified and living for God, we became somebody. Amen. One of the most devastating things that could ever happen is to wake up and not know who you are. Amen. Whether it's due due to amnesia or Alzheimer, amen, not knowing who you are is detrimental to your survival. And it's frustrating to the ones around you, amen. Sometimes we have a memory lapse and forget who we are in God, amen. We forget the authority that we have in God. We forget the benefits that we have in God. And believe it or not, amen, when we do that, it causes frustration to God. Think about it. God said, after all I've done for you and you forgot who you were, amen, after I brought you out of this and I brought you out of that, you forgot your testimony, amen, glory to God. We have to know who we are, amen. Sometimes when we're faced with challenges of life, amen, we forget just who we are in Christ Jesus, amen. We forget that we grow in grace, amen. As we grow in grace, we also grow in the knowledge of Jesus Christ. We forget that the old things are passed away, and behold, all things have become new, amen. We forget, amen, that when we came on this side of salvation, amen, we don't do the things that we used to do anymore. We don't go to places that we used to go anymore, amen. We cannot forget who we are.
Yes, yes, yes.
Now we got a God on our side, amen, and God will be with us through the fire. He'll be with you through the flood. He'll be with you through the backbiting and the gossiping, amen. He'll be with you, amen. Glory to God. We got to know who we are. And the enemy wants us to forget who we are. He wants to forget who we have been identified with. Amen. Listen, I'm a royal child. I've been adopted into a royal family. I'm kept by the power of God. Amen. Glory to God. Let me talk about that. Listen, adoption gives you a new identity. Oh my God. Listen to this. Listen, listen, listen. Listen, before we were adopted into the royal family, we were sinners. We were born in sin. We were shaped in iniquity, amen. Oh, but when the Lord saved us, amen, he gave us a brand new identity. Because when he saved us, he adopted us, amen. We were destined for destruction, amen. And when the Lord adopted us, he gave us a divine destiny, amen. Oh, when God saved us, we were adopted. We were engrafted into his family. Now we are heirs and joint heirs with Christ, amen. Adoption is really better than being born into a family. Amen. Because when you were born in a family, you didn't have no control over what kind of family you were born into. Amen. Your family could have been dysfunctional. Your family could have been crazy. You had no choice. Amen. And let me tell you, they had no choice what kind of child you were going to be. Or when you were adopted, that means somebody took time out to look among so many others and said, I want that one. Somebody chose you personally. And that's what God did. God said, I want you. I want you. Brothers of God. Hey, we were chosen out of so many others, chosen to be adopted to the family of God by God. And when he adopted us, he gave us his name. Amen. Brothers of God. Beloved, now are we the sons of God. Amen. He gave us his spirit. He gave us his power. And he gave us the benefits of salvation. Amen. We're no longer our own, but we belong to God. Amen. Glory to God. So we've been adopted. We've been adopted, Minister Mays. Amen. When somebody asks you who you are, tell them you're a child of the King because you've been adopted. Glory to God. Listen, I don't have to be with the brothers, you know, they're talking about the black Hebrews. I don't have to be a black Hebrew. I just got to be me, amen, because I've been adopted into the family. I got the same benefits as the family. Amen. I'm going to heaven just like the Jews. Why? Because I've been adopted into the family. Yay. Glory to God. Amen, amen, amen. Bible calls us a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people. We've been adopted into the family. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen, amen. Listen, don't worry about folks who want to accept the new you, your new identity in Christ. Amen. Don't worry about them. Sister Quinn, don't worry about folks that, you know, you got some folks, the minute, you know, you met them, you know, you might not have seen in about 10, 15 years. Amen. And the last time you saw them, you might not have been saved. You might have always gone to church, but you might not have been saved. Amen. And then you tell me, you know, I say, what you been up to? Ooh, well, child, I'm in church. I'm saved now. You saved. You said, you.
Not you. I heard it.
You know, you. Like, you know, you ought to take offense to that. Amen. Some of us, we were some cut-ups. Amen. But you. The Lord saved you. You sure? Amen. Glory to God. way you used to be. Amen. You got some family members who never accept that you're saved because they remember when. Because they only see you as the person they grew up with. Amen. That's why Jesus' own brothers and sisters couldn't understand how he could claim to be the Son of God. And they remember him growing up in the house. He was an older brother. They knew Mary being the mother and Joseph being the daddy. We should come on talking about he's the Son of God.
Yes.
Amen. Yes. Listen, from the world's point of view, we are viewed as the same as we have always been. Amen. We're viewed with the same baggage that we've always carried. Amen. But we have to know our true identity in the Lord. Amen. Well, God has done the changes from the inside out. Amen. And knowing that he set us free from the world's constraints and expectations, knowing that he set us free from our past, knowing that he set us free from the garbage that we used to be in, amen, knowing that he set us free, amen, amen, from all of the bonds that we were bound in, amen. Listen, knowing that he set that girl free to come off the corner, amen, knowing that he set that drug addict free, amen, we got to understand that who the Son has set free is free indeed.
Yes.
Woo! Everybody's not going to accept you. Everybody's not going to like you, but just walk upright anyway. Amen. Just let them know who you are anyway. Listen, you don't have an ID card to carry, but what you have is your testimony. Hey, glory to God. I was from an outcast, a stranger on earth, a sinner by charge. Amen. Glory to God, but now I'm adopted. I'm in a royal family. Hallelujah. Woo. Your ID is the Spirit of God that lives down on the inside of you. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Listen, you might not believe it, but you'll see it because my life is a living epistle and I'll be right on me. Glory to God. Listen. My mind goes to David. David was a shepherd boy. Amen. His whole family could not even see past who he was. Amen. David was destined to be the king of Israel, but his own family couldn't see him being anything more than just a shepherd boy. Amen. When Samuel came to anoint one of Jesse's sons as king, amen, Jesse called all of the big, strong sons, amen. Didn't even think about calling David, amen. He called up all these sons before Jesse. And Jesse said, no, that's not the one. No, that's not the one. I mean, Samuel said, that's not the one. That's not the one, amen. And he said, wait a minute. You got any other sons? He said, well, I got this little boy back in the backyard with the sheep, amen. David. He said, go get David. And when David came, Samuel said, that's the one. Listen. Jesse couldn't believe it. The brothers couldn't believe it. You mean David?